Dedia from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology in Department of Electronics and Communication. Today we will discuss the subject that is control system design, and in control system design we will discuss our unit number 2, that is design of state variable feedback system. And our today's topic is what is the solution of the state equation. See, in our earlier session we discussed how to find out the state transition matrix, that is one method, that is you just take the Laplace and take inverse Laplace, and the second method, that is to find out the state transition matrix, is Kelly-Hamilton method. And then we discussed the solution for the state space equation, that is how to find out the transfer function from the state space equations. Now we will discuss the solution of the state equations. So let's start our today's session. So first of all, we will study the time response. So before that, you just consider the equation, that is x dot that equal to ax plus b. Now you just take the Laplace transform. So what you have, that is s into x of s minus x of 0, a into x of s plus b into u of s. See, because it is difficult to find out the x of t from this equations, right? Because we have a differentiation. If we want to cancel out that differentiation, then we have to take the integration. So the best solution is what? We will take the Laplace and then we will take the inverse Laplace. So the Laplace of this is become s into x of s minus x of 0, that equal to a into x of s plus b into u of s. Now this is s into x of s minus a into x of s, that equal to x of 0 plus b into u of s. See here, we cannot take x of 0 that equal to 0 because we are not finding the transfer function. We have to take initial condition that equal to 0 when we are finding the transfer function. So here you just write down s into x of s minus a into x of s, that equal to x of 0 plus b into u of s. Now take the x of s common. So what we have as I minus a, that equal to x of 0 plus b into u of s. Now here, see, the value of x of s, that is what? You have to divide this equation with the fi minus a. So here, this side we will have only x of s. Now here, that is x of 0, that is fi minus a inverse. And then fi minus a inverse b into u of s. Now next, this is my equation. Now we have to take the Laplace of this, inverse Laplace of this, because we just take, we want to find out x of t. So to convert x of s into x of t, we have to take what is the inverse Laplace. So inverse Laplace is what? Laplace inverse of s I minus a inverse into x of 0 plus Laplace inverse of s I minus a inverse into b into u of s. And that is what? See, the Laplace inverse of, if you remember, si minus a inverse is nothing but the phi of t, state transition matrix, into x of 0 plus Laplace inverse of phi of s into u of s. Because the phi of s is what? It's a 1 upon si minus a. Now, see, you have to use this formula to find out the x of t. Now, let's solve one example. Here we want to obtain the time response for the following data, that is x1 dot x2 dot, that equal to 1 0 0 1 x1 x2 plus 1 1 into u. Now where the u of t is the unit step occurring at t equal to 0. And here one more thing is given to you, that is x of transpose 0, that equal to 1 0. This is what is the initial condition. So here x of 0, that we have to consider 1 and 0. Here this transpose is given to us. Now to find out the x of t, first of all you just write down this equation, that is x of t, that equal to phi of t into x of 0 plus Laplace inverse of phi of s into b into u of s. Now we know that pi of t is what? It's a e raised to et, and pi of s is what? It's a 1 upon si minus a. That is nothing but the si minus a inverse. So ultimately we want to find out si minus a. So you just write down the matrix A. So si minus a is as 1 0 0 1 minus 1 1 0 1. So this is nothing but si minus s minus 1 0 minus 1 and then s minus 1. Now magnitude of si minus a is what? Cross multiplication. So what you get? S minus 1 whole square minus 0. That is nothing but the S minus 1 whole square. Now see, we want to find out the adjoint of SI minus A. Why? Because SI minus A inverse is nothing but the adjoint of SI minus A upon SI minus A. How we can calculate the adjoint? We know very well. We can interchange just 2 and then interchange the sign. So here S minus 1 is same value. So just S minus 1 and interchange the sign. So the minus 1 will become plus 1. Now what we will do? You just separate the denominator. So pi of s will be 1 upon S minus 1. 1 divided by S minus 1 whole square. Then 0, 1 upon S minus 1. Now pi of t is what? It's the inverse of pi of s. So what is the inverse of 1 upon s minus 1? Because see, in a matrix, when you want to take the inverse, at that time each and every element you have to write down inverse. So first row, first column, that is 1 upon s minus 1. The inverse is what? It's e raised to t. Now the inverse of 0, first row, second column is 0. Now consider second row, first column. See, the 1 upon s minus 1 whole square. If you remember, then that is the inverse of t into e raised to t. And last one is 1 upon s minus 1. See, the inverse is what? It's e raised to t. Right. So to find out the state transition matrix, or we can see the time response, you require the knowledge of Laplace as well as inverse Laplace. Now see, in this we have the value of pi of t, that is e raised to t, 0, t into e raised to t and e raised to t. We have the value of pi of s, that is what? 1 upon s minus a, 1 upon this s minus a whole square, 0 and 1 upon s minus 1. Now see, the x of 0 is 1 0 because the transpose is given to us 1 0. So you just convert this row into column. Now and we have b, that is already given in the question 1 1. Now we have all this value. Simply substitute this all value in above equation. Now here u of s is missing. But for that, in a question that you have written, that is for unit step. And we know that the Laplace of unit step is what? 1 by s. Right. If it is a rare, then you have to write down the Laplace of rare. If it is a parabolic, then you have to write down the Laplace of parabolic function. So simply substitute all this value in above equation. So x of t will be e raised to t 0, t e raised to t 1 0, and then Laplace inverse of 1 upon s minus 1, 1 upon x minus 1 whole square, 0, 1 upon s minus 1, 1 1, and you have to multiply that with the u of s. So this is my equation. So first of all, you just multiply this 2. So first row, first column, so only we have a 1 e raised to t. Then second row, first column. So what we get? T into e raised to t. Now Laplace inverse as it is, multiply this 2 matrix. So first row, first column, what we have? 1 upon s minus 1. Now second row, first column. So what we have? 1 upon s minus 1 whole square plus s minus 1 multiplied by 1 by s. Now here e raised to t t into e raised to t. Laplace inverse of 1 upon s minus 1. Here you just take the LCM. So 1 plus s minus 1 upon s minus 1 whole square multiplied by 1 by s. So what we have? This, that is e raised to t into t e raised to t, Laplace inverse of 1 upon s minus 1, then s into s minus 1 whole square. Now multiply this with the 1 by s. So we will get this. Now is it possible to directly write down the inverse of this? No, we don't know the direct inverse. But yes, we know the direct inverse of 1 upon s minus 1 whole square. But to find out the inverse of 1 upon s minus 1, we will use the method that is partial fraction. So a by s plus b upon s minus 1. So here what we have? 1 that equal to a into s minus 1, b into s. Now open the bracket. So a is minus a plus b is. Take the s common. So a plus b into s minus a. Compare the coefficients, that is a plus b that equal to 0 minus a that equal to 1. So a equal to minus 1 and b equal to 1. So simply substitute here, that is minus 1 by s plus 1 upon s minus 1. So the inverse of minus 1 by s is 1, it's a minus 1, plus inverse of this term, that is what? It's a e raised to t. Now, see, this is what, it's a Laplace of 1 upon, inverse Laplace of 1 upon s minus 1. And the inverse Laplace of 1 upon s minus 1 whole square, that is t into e raised to t. Simply put this two value over here. Now, see here. So what we have, e raised to t into e raised to t plus minus 1 plus e raised to t into e raised to t. Simply what we want to do, we can add this two matrix. So what we have, that is e raised to t minus 1 plus e raised to t into e raised to t plus t into e raised to t. So you just solve this, what we get? 2 into e raised to t minus 1, 2t into e raised to t. Right. So this way you can find out the solution of the state equations, that is x of t. I hope this session is clear. Thank you.